your sense of observation in the painting. When we work in the department, as you know, police department is a service-oriented department. We call it a service. So when we do this service, there is lot of planning, lot of effort, lot of hard work. And when we see small children like you, observing it, appreciating it, it is like a big reward for all of us. This is like, as Jitendra said, you are the future of our country. The entire growth, development of our country will depend on your generation. Therefore, a very small example I want to give. All the IPS officers of the country, they are trained at Sardar Vallabh Bhai Patel National Police Academy. It is located at Shivrampalli. Some of you must have seen it. When you enter the gates of National Police Academy at Shivrampalli, there is a big rock, big boulder, very big, almost 15 to 20 feet big rock. And underneath that rock, there is a quotation. There is a quotation of a famous Greek sculptor called Michelangelo. You must have heard about Michelangelo. So somebody asked Michelangelo that how do you make such beautiful statues out of these barren rocks? The original rocks are without any shape, without any design, without any polish, without any shape. And from those rocks, Michelangelo used to make statues which look as if it's a live human being. It will talk. That was the greatness of Michelangelo. Michelangelo replied that I do not make the statue. There is a statue in every rock. I just give a little chisel here and there and the statue comes out. Now, you may wonder that why that rock is kept at National Police Academy. There must be some relevance. The relevance is that there is a policeman in every human being. Every child, every man, every woman, every person has a policeman inside. It has to be just little chisel. And you see the difference in the country. The only difference is that we are wearing uniform, khaki color or white color depending on traffic or law and order. And we are trying to do something. But the heart of heart, every individual wants that things should be regulated. Nobody wants that there should be confusion on the road, chaos in the society, crime in society. Everyone wants and desires that there should be orderness. There should be regulation. And that is the urge of every individual which we have to nurture. As a young boy and girl, I would suggest and I would impress upon each one of you that whenever you see anything wrong, whenever you see anything which you don't like, don't keep it to yourself. Share it with someone whom you trust. Tell your parents, tell your relatives, tell your school teachers, tell any policeman. Nothing bad, you should keep it to yourself. Immediately tell or share it with someone. That is the biggest service with regard to regulation, enforcement, everything discipline you can do. The painting which we have seen just now, I need not repeat that all of you have already exhibited that you are sincere and very hardworking. And that is what I was about to say before I was coming here, and when I started from my office, I was thinking, what should I say? I was so happy to see the paintings that shows each one of you full of enthusiasm, full of hard work, and I'm sure with continuation of all these things, you will make a very successful human being in life. I also take this opportunity to express my sincere thanks to all the teachers here. In our society, I think no profession is as noble as that of a school teacher. Whatever we are, each one of us, whatever we are, it is only because in the early years of our life, we were privileged to have good teachers. It is something which is a rare opportunity. And I would like to remind all the children here that always see yourself, compare yourself to other part of the country, other part of the globe, where there are children who are not as blessed as you are. You are living in a wonderful city, you are studying at good schools, excellent teachers. There are many children in the world, in the country, who are not getting these facilities. Therefore, it is all the more important for you that all the facilities which you are having, use it to the maximum, utilize it to the maximum, improve your skill, and above all, make yourself a better human being every day. I would like to say a few words about my colleagues in the traffic department here, traffic branch. All of you are aware that police department has various branches: crime, forensic science, armed reserve, police stations, law and order, and traffic. Now, traffic is the most visible organ of the police department. Can you imagine, in the month of April, May, June, when temperature touches 45, 47 degree also sometimes, our constables, who are like us, same human being, they stand at the crossroads of Abbots, Panjagutta, SR Nagar, Lakdi Ka Pul, everywhere, withstanding the temperature of 40 plus degree, inhaling all the carbon monoxide which is emitted by the vehicle, and performing their duty every day. I don't think there is any other job physically as taxing as that of a constable on the road where doing traffic duty. They also help children, elderly people cross the road, and so on and so forth. Have that compassion towards people. Once you grow up, once you become executives in various companies, once you take up other jobs, have this compassion and concern for others, and try to always see things from their point of view, their perspective also. That is something which is very much required. Know your colleagues, know the surrounding, know the people who are serving you. If you will realize this, it will make you to become a better human being and a responsible citizen. And since this is organized by the traffic branch, I will appeal all children here that whenever you see any of your relatives doing anything wrong with regard to traffic, immediately point out. You are the traffic policeman and traffic policewoman of future and also of present. How to cross a road, where to cross a road, importance of zebra crossing, traffic lights, these are all very simple things. Very, very simple thing. And if you develop the habit of obeying all these regulations from now, don't you think that after 5 years you will have a better society? Definitely yes. with your effort, with your sincerity, I am sure all of us will work towards a better place. And in future, wherever you are working, all of you may not be working in Hyderabad. Somebody may get a job somewhere else. But the foundation which your school is giving here, the foundation which your city is giving you here, that foundation will remain with you throughout your life. So I once again thank all the officers of traffic police for giving me this opportunity to interact with young children here. And I pay my respect once again to all the teachers whom I have utmost regard. It is not possible for me to remember, otherwise long back I had read a letter of American President Abraham Lincoln, who had written a letter to the school teacher when his son was going to school. May I just request the teachers that if it is possible, please, at your convenient time, please read that letter to all the children in your class. It is very interesting letter. It is available on internet, and please go through it. And last but not the least, all my love and affection to the children. May God bless you. May you succeed in whatever you do in future, and be a very good student. Thank you so much.